Hello, this is Scott, and this is a Hype Report. Today's report is sponsored by the free book Ramblings of a Madman. Here are the quotes for various items. First, Swiss exports. According to Swiss authorities, at 2,777 tons, gold exports out of Switzerland rose 76.9% last year. Silver export rose 10% in dollar terms and 47% weight-wise. It does not take a genius to realize it was not heading for the US, UK, or even Zimbabwe as the precious metal flow continues from west to east. At some point, this flow will cease, and when it does, that's when it will hit the fan. Next, Iran does it right. A billionaire businessman at the heart of a $2.6 billion state bank scam in Iran, the largest fraud case in that country since 1970, was executed. Yet, in the U.S., John Corzine, who made $1.6 billion vaporized, is still walking around? Makes one wonder. Next, Walmart. If there's one indicator of the state of the global economy, it's consumer purchasing on the retail level. Walmart's U.S. domestic sales have dropped and their international sales have collapsed, signaling serious trouble ahead. Like it or not, as Gerald Celente has said, as goes Walmart, so goes America. Next, counting guns. The Justice Department is updating a report on how many guns the federal government has. So, will they use the hexadecimal numbering system where 1,000 base 16 is 4,096 in the decimal system? Next, quota system for child theft. According to a Child Protection Service informant, there is a quota system just like cops have, except it is children being stolen instead of citizens merely receiving speeding tickets. This is apparently just the tip of the proverbial iceberg in an agency full of people whom do not have any children of their own. Next, 50 ways to earn a living. Here are a few ways to earn a living in both pre- and post-collapse. 1. Carpentry. 2. Biodiesel production. 3. Distilling spirits. 4. Water purification. 5. Shoe repairs. 6. Soap and candle making. 7. Building chicken coops. Next, rating higher education. $150 billion goes to students seeking higher education. Obama's going to rate schools on the following. 1. How many of these students who receive government loans or grants graduate? 2. Student debt load upon graduation. 3. How much did the student earn after graduating? These public facts will drive students to better degrees in schools, and many highly paid school administrators are afraid. Finally, please prepare now for the escalating economic and social unrest. Good day!